Welcome to TalkFCB and welcome back here to the channel, guys, to a news roundup here today. Earlier on, we did play our second game of pre-season and we were victorious. That match review is on the channel, but right here today, we're going to be talking about, again, an official announcement from the club. We're going to be talking about Junior Firpo. There's news on Suarez. There's news on Messi. And of course, if you think Real Madrid are going to concede 7 goals and I'm not going to talk about it, well, you were wrong. I am. At the end of this video, Atletico against Real. Everything you need to know, it's coming right up. Let's get into this. But let's start first and foremost with that official announcement coming yesterday from Barcelona, and it was one that we were expecting. We had spoken about it. It was about Pep Segura. He has gone. Pep Segura is no longer an employee of FC Barcelona, and that's massive, massive news. It really is. Yesterday, Barcelona came out, officially confirmed there. Segura and the club had reached an agreement there between the two to terminate his contract as Barcelona's general manager. And like I said before, guys, I was really, really happy to hear this was going to happen. A few days ago, we spoke about the implications of that, the restructuring right now that's going on within the board, the fact that Eric Abidal now will hold more authority, he'll make more of the big decisions. That's really, really important. Pep Segura was not leading the club in the right direction, and I was also quite impressed there with Barcelona's statement. Usually, when people leave, usually when managers and board members leave, there's quite a big statement there, thanking them, going over their achievements and things like that. With this one, it was one or two lines. Thank you to Segura, and on your way now. Barcelona, very blunt there, issuing him out the door. And as we spoke about before, a great move for the club. And of course, a big step in the right direction for the future of FC Barcelona. And I want to talk here once again about our pursuit of Junior Firpo. And this, of course, comes after Ernesto Valverde prior to today's game. He spoke about left back. He was asked basically whether Barcelona are going to be signing somebody in this transfer window. And Valverde pretty much did confirm we do want somebody. We do want to bring somebody in at left back. The club are doing what they can right now to go and get that done. And I want to talk here about Junior Firpo, who for the first time here has spoken publicly about Barcelona's interest, and a very, very timely interview here with Mundo Deportivo. And I just want to go over a few things that he said. There was a few very interesting topics in here that I do want to bring you, starting off with this. He said, it's a massive, massive compliment for me and a big, big pride to be linked with a club like Barcelona. He said, right now, I'm at Real Betis. Whatever happens is going to happen this summer. I can't control that. But he said, right now, it's an honour for me to be linked with Barcelona. He said, Jordi Alba is the best left back in the world, a great player capable of defending and also attacking there with a lot of purpose. If one day I can play by his side, apart from just competing with him, I'm sure that I can learn a lot from somebody like Jordi Alba. Very interesting there. And I think also important to note here, a lot of people have been saying, well, what about previous tweets? A few things have been dragged up about Junior Firpo that was tweeted a long, long time ago, many years we're talking. And he'd speak about those tweets there about Barcelona and about Lionel Messi. He said, tweets in the past is something that doesn't matter right now. I can explain myself. I can explain everything without any problem. He said, my best friend at the time was a Barcelona fan. I was 15 years old. I was a kid. And it was basically a bit of banter there between the two. That's what he said there. He said, it's kid stuff. It's back in the past. He said he was a Barcelona fan. I said some things to sort of wind him up. That's the kind of thing we're talking about here. Back when he was just 15 years old, he said, I didn't really realize what sort of impact it would have on my career later on, many, many years down the line. He said, if anybody feels offended by those tweets, I will apologise, no doubt about that. I'll do it humbly and without any hesitation, I will say sorry. Firpo then went on to say, Lionel Messi for me is the best player in the world without any question, and I say that when I talk about the Ballon d'Or. He said there was no surprise when the Real Betis fans applauded Lionel Messi at the Benito Villamarine earlier on this season. He said it was a spectacular goal, a spectacular display. This year, like I say, Messi has to win the Ballon d'Or again. He was top goal scorer in La Liga, he was the Golden Boot winner, and also the top goal scorer in the Champions League. Junior Firpo there said, who has done more than Messi? And quite clearly there, he's very, very open to coming. An honour to be linked. The only question now is when and if Barcelona are going to agree that fee. And I do believe now, when the club, when Bartomeu, when the board, when the players, when they return to Spain, we are going to see a few more deals getting done, hopefully, a few more things getting over the line. And we should hear some news very, very shortly on Junior Firpo. But I do now want to come on to a current Barcelona player and somebody who we haven't seen for quite a few weeks. It's Luis Suarez. He is now back back in Barcelona. He returned yesterday to some training. He was doing some individual work at the Ciutat Esportiva Joan Gamper. Just some individual training there. He's on a specific program to get himself up to speed as quickly as possible. And that, for me, is really good to see. See Suarez there back out in the field doing some work, getting himself really prepared for the players to come back and to get himself integrated once again back within the rest of the group. He doesn't actually start training with the rest of the team there until Wednesday, the 31st of July. But clearly here, he wants to get himself really, really quickly back up to speed. And that's a good thing. I think what we all want to see here is a motivated, driven, sharp Luis Suarez who's fighting there to get his place in the team and hold on to it, of course, with the arrival of Antoine Griezmann. Good there to see Luis Suarez back in some training. Also yesterday, arrived back in Barcelona, the city, was Lionel Messi. He was pictured there on arrival into Barcelona. And certainly, that's good news as well. We can't wait to see Messi back on the field. We can't wait to see Messi there back in training. But it's actually here his contract situation that I do want to discuss in today's video. After some reports have emerged very recently from ESPN in Spain, that the club basically have already begun the process of renewing Lionel Messi's contract at Barcelona. ESPN say that Bartomeu himself will be leading those contract negotiations and he'll be dealing directly there with Lionel Messi's father, George, who of course also acts as his agent. But I think it's quite interesting here because quite a while now, I think we've all known that Bartomeu not only wants to keep Messi at the club, obviously that has to be a priority for any president of Barcelona, but I think also in Bartomeu's mind, he wants to be the man to really tie Messi down. He wants to be the president to actually here keep Messi at the club beyond his current contract, which expires in 2021. And also, of course, coincidentally, that happens to be the time there where Bartomeu effectively will leave his role as Barcelona president when the elections happen, of course, in 2021. And so, like I say, Bartomeu there wants to be the man to renew Messi one more time, at least eyeing a new deal here, which will run until 2023, which will see Lionel Messi continue at the club until he's at least 36 years old. And of course, whether it's Bartomeu's wish, whether it's something that he wants to do, we're of course focused here on the fact that Messi must remain at Barcelona. That's all that we want as Barcelona fans, to keep seeing Messi year in, year out on the field. That's what we all get joy from. And I think we all realise here that Messi does deserve these renewals. Yes, they do come quite frequently. Yes, he's quite clearly the highest paid player at Barcelona. But at the end of the day, if you had to give that to somebody, Messi is the man who certainly earns that over and over again. And certainly here, when Messi puts pen to paper, which I'm sure that he will, there's never really any problem with getting Messi to renew. Once it's put in front of him, he is going to be staying at Barcelona. And that, of course, is something which every single one of us, we're going to be behind that. But of course, guys, I did promise you to talk here just slightly away from Barcelona matters as such. Real Madrid against Atletico Madrid in the International Champions Cup, which happened actually late last night. It was a big game, and I have to say, it was an extremely exciting pre-season match. It finished Real Madrid 3, Atletico Madrid, their massive, massive rivals, 7. 7-3, Real Madrid were defeated there by Atletico Madrid. The first thing I'll say is, yes, it's pre-season. The second thing I'll say is, I'm still going to get excited about this. I'm still going to laugh. And yes, even Atletico Madrid right now, with everything that's going on with Griezmann, they're not exactly high on our friendship list. But at the same time, to put 7 goals there past Real Madrid is absolutely remarkable. Diego Costa on the night, scoring 4 times. 4 goals there for Diego Costa. And in typical Diego Costa style, he scored 4, but also ended up getting sent off. Both Dani Carvajal and Diego Costa there getting sent off in the second half. But Atletico here, they were unbelievable. João Felix, of course, the record signing, big, big money signing they brought in. A lot of pressure on his shoulders this season to deliver. And certainly, in this game, he really did deliver. He only scored once on the night, but he was really involved there in Diego Costa's goals. He provided some really good assists. He was looking good in his overall play. And certainly, the Atletico were looking really fresh, looking really sharp. And in their shape as well, Simeone there, very, very good signs for Atletico Madrid, and certainly this season, they are going to be a threat. They were 5-0 up, 5-0 up at halftime there against Real Madrid, and this is a Real Madrid team, by the way, which is very, very much so towards full strength. Eden Hazard was out there, Luka Jovic, players like that. There was Toni Kroos in midfield, Luka Modric, Isco, Ramos, Nacho. There's a lot of players in there, certainly for Real Madrid, which shouldn't have been on the end of this kind of loss. They were 6-0 down then, it then went to 6-2, then it actually went to 7-1 when Vitolo scored 20
90 minutes from time, but luckily for Real Madrid, just to spare a few of their blushes, in the last 5 minutes they did score two late goals to actually there reduce it to 7-3, but a massive loss there in pre-season. Yes, it's pre-season. Yes, of course, the result doesn't matter in hindsight, but at the same time here, there are some worrying signs going into the campaign for Zinedine Zidane, who I feel, of course, they brought in new players, they've got a very, very good squad, but sometimes at Real Madrid, that's just not enough. Sometimes there's something there that's catastrophically wrong, and here Atletico Madrid really tore them to shreds, and this season in La Liga, oh, it's going to be exciting. It really, really is. And so that there, guys, brings us to a close on the Barcelona news right now. Barca, of course, finishing their pre-season tour of Japan today. They're already on the plane now, back to Barcelona. And of course, when they do arrive back home there in Barcelona, they're going to have a good amount of training now before our next game on the 4th of August against Arsenal in the Joan Gamper Trophy. I'll bring you up to speed with everything that happens between now and then. Thank you, as always, for watching, guys. Thank you for your support. I will see you soon. But until next time, as always, Visca! El Barça.